everyone, I'm Tor, this is Sophie. We're just going to be talking today a little bit about the pelvic floor because the word gets thrown around quite a lot and there's a lot of women that come into this clinic for women's health treatment and you know, don't really know what the pelvic floor is, what it does. So I've grabbed Sophie today just to talk about it. So firstly, I think our first question is, where is it? Like, where is the pelvic floor? And I think Sophie's got a lovely model to show off.
So I think it's easier if we show you on a model, but basically the pelvic floor is the floor of the pelvis. So if this is the hip bones here, and this is the front of the hips, so it's sort of this position of the hips. What we're looking at is the superficial layer of the pelvic floor, which extends from the tailbone to the pubic bone, and then the two sit bones. So the superficial layer involves the squeezing muscle, so it includes the external anal sphincter around the back. It includes the muscles around the front, which help to squeeze to close the vagina, and then the support muscles on either side, connecting to the sit bones. They're more our hips control, pelvic floor, and they're sort of the superficial layer. So then we have inside the pelvis, I don't think you can see very well there, is the deeper layer, which extends again towards the coccyx and then to the pubic bone at the front, and they're more our lifting muscles. So there are a couple of layers of the pelvic floor muscles, but there's also skin that covers around the pelvis, and then fascia, which is also considered part of the pelvic floor.